Hi guys, I'm Katherine, and today I'll be reading chapter 2 of Junie B. Jones and the Stupid Smelly Bus. Feeling squeezy. I stayed scared about the bus for a whole week, and last night when my mother tucked me into bed, I still felt sickish about it. Guess what? I said, I don't think I want to ride that bus to kindergarten tomorrow. Then my mother rumpled my hair. Oh, sure you do, she said. Oh, sure I don't, I said back. Then mother kissed me and said, it'll be fun. You'll see. Don't worry. I did, though. I worried very much, and I didn't sleep so good either. And this morning, I felt very droopy when I got up, and my stomach was squeezy, and I couldn't eat my cereal. And so I watched TV until mother said it was time to get ready to go. Then I put on my shirt that looked like velvet, and my new fuzzy pink sweater, and I ate half a tuna sandwich for lunch. After that, mother and I walked to the corner to wait for the bus. And guess what? There was another mother and a little girl there too. The little girl had curly black hair, which is my favorite kind of head. I didn't say hello to her though, because she was from a different street, that's why. Then finally, the big yellow bus came around the corner, and the brakes screeched very loud. I had to cover my ears. Then the door opened. The bus driver said, hi, I'm Mr. Wu, hop on. Except I didn't hop on, because my legs didn't want to. I don't think I want to ride this bus to kindergarten, I told my mother. Then she gave me a little push. Go on, Junie B, she said. Mr. Wu is waiting for you. Be a big girl and get on. I looked up at the windows. The little girl with the curly black hair was already in the bus. She looked very big sitting up there and kind of happy. Look at how big that little girl's acting, Junie B, said mother. Why don't you sit right next to her? It'll be fun, I promise. So I got on the bus, and guess what? It wasn't fun. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. See you next time.